Oh no. Mm-mm.
I feel like anxiety.
That felt like I'm about to be murdered, which I'm sort of questioning right now.
The South Korean survival drama Squid Game became the most watched series in Netflix history. And while the smash hit plays upon familiar horror tropes to create tension and discomfort, the composer of Squid Game, Jae-il Jung, employed a deeper set of musical tools to psychologically terrify audiences. But just how much do these tools affect them? In this episode of Music Lab, we're hooking viewers up to an EKG machine, which monitors heart activity, to find out how much of a physiological effect Squid Game's music can have on the human body.
I feel like I'm on a Nickelodeon set right now.
Am I gonna get electrocuted? Should I take my necklace off?
The first of several techniques Jae-il Jung uses is the DSE ray, a Gregorian chant that originated in the 13th century. In Latin, the phrase translates to Day of Wrath. This descending minor chord progression has haunted humanity for centuries, reminiscent of a torturous history that includes the Spanish Inquisition. For our first experiment, we're going to see how our subjects react to more soothing music compared to the DSE ray in Squid Game score.
I feel calm, like I should have tea.
I'm thinking about like going out to like a nice dinner.
I feel like I should do the minuet.
For some reason, it makes me feel like I'm in a daycare center.
It was taking me to a happy place.
That was really kind of pleasant. Like I want to get on my tiptoes and dance around.
Now, let's see how they react to the DSE ray. Pay close attention to the red EKG line to see how the frequency of heartbeat increases compared to our baseline.
I didn't really want to get on my tiptoes with that one.
It makes me want to drive faster.
Kind of like anxiety, like a buildup of something.
That felt like I'm about to be murdered, which I'm sort of questioning right now.
And usually African Americans, we die in the first credit. So it made me feel like a horror.
Next, we tested the effectiveness of nonlinear sound. These are sounds too loud or dissonant to fall into the typical range of vocal cords or musical instruments. Nonlinear sound exploits the brain's aversion to distressing noises. It's a tool that many horror composers utilize to amplify the effect of implied narrative tension. To start our second experiment, we played another pleasant song as a baseline.
Tis the season for sure. Is this a Christmas song? What is this? What song is this?
Ah, Ode to Joy.
I feel a lot more relaxed.
That one was very, very therapeutic. Like, I could definitely see myself using that to calm my nerves.
Now, let's try our nonlinear sound. Like last time, watch the EKG for differences in heartbeat frequency.
This is terrible. Yeah, glad that one's over.
I feel like a little bit of anxiety.
Feels like I'm shooting through the wormhole.
Yeah, it makes you feel like you're like, no!
Lastly, we looked at the effectiveness of Squid Game's anempathetic sound. This technique consists of applying a score or sound design that exhibits a disregard for the tone, emotion, or plot of a scene. Squid Game notably uses serene, classical pieces, and juvenile instruments to juxtapose unsettling visuals of death and terror. For this final experiment, let's begin by playing Squid Game's cover of Fly Me to the Moon.
You are all I long for, all I worship best.
Very seductive.
It's like some fireplace music.
Feels like I'm in a romantic comedy in the 90s.
I love this. It's very calm, like imagining being on like a gondola.
I was seeing kind of Paris with the moon rising.
It made me feel very wanted. Like loved, like somebody wants me, somebody wants to do it to me.
I like that one, can we play it again?
We sure can. But this time, let's show it the way it was used in an episode. Once again, keep an eye on the EKG.
Oh no. Mm-mm. No. You are all I long for, all I worship
and adore. Not the words, please be true. In other
words, I love you. Run, man.
Okay. Wow. That's dark, y'all.
It was a different feeling with that song. I didn't feel loved.
That took Paris away. The blood and gore and that lovely song that was kind of like that.
You ruined that song for me, man.
I mean, jazz is always a little dangerous.
When I initially listened to it, I was like, oh, this is lighthearted and free. And, you know, I can see this in a Meg Ryan movie for sure. And then I felt like this like intense like darkness with the song. It was kind of beautiful, honestly.
Fear, anxiety, anticipation. These emotions all play on one very basic human desire, fulfillment. With the right musical technique, we can leave an audience waiting on the edge of their seat and even change their experience of a scene in dramatic ways. And so, as our EKG experiment showed, these techniques can cause real physiological responses. Let us know how Squid Game affected you in the comments below. We'll catch you next time in the Netflix Music Lab.